Background music and ambience brought to you in part by Midnight Syndicate. Music for the imagination and the perfect musical accompaniment for the Dungeons & Dragons role-playing game. Seem, and people are not who they appear to be, where puns run rampant through the streets, and it's hard to tell who the real monsters are. Finally, the culmination of two epic campaigns, three heroes fighting to keep the world of Euphray from ripping apart, against three villains who conspire to thwart the efforts of Gagmi, and where the fate of Tim and Terry hangs in the balance. Now, let's join Sir Thaddeus Trebilcock, the wild magic sorcerer, Francis the Lion, the gladiator bard, Malphaedor, the fallen Asmar Oathbreaker, Ayda, the drow rogue, McNastly, the half-halfling, half-fainting satyr bard, and the rogue warlock Hesh von Eggars. As they each continue in their relentless pursuit of
a fool's quest.
So you guys land at Nortuga's Reef, and it is a very rustic-looking island. The houses are made of stone, and they have very, very solid-looking builds to everything that they have. The dock wood looks like it was freshly built this year. Everything here is very beautiful, very crafted, structurally sound. Everything that you can notice about it is high quality. And a couple of Asmar meet you. Well, they meet Borf and Bordy, who are now dual captains. they
literally
rotate.
Dual captains.
Co-captains.
So they meet them at the bottom of the ramp. They have a quick discussion, and it is decided that a cleric is going to come out of the city and check over each person that's coming off the boat before they go into Nortuga's Reef.
Probably a good idea.
So you wait on the boat for about another half hour until the cleric arrives. And the cleric is an Asmar. And very finely dressed Asmar. And wearing a cloak that reflects Greyhawk.
Shit biscuits.
Okay, so is this going to be a problem?
Better not be.
What is the priest checking us for specifically? Just making sure we look healthy.
It's a COVID check.
The zombie check.
Just making sure we look healthy, like not doing like super in-depth check that I can tell.
Do you want to wait for a couple of the other passengers to go first to see what happens?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So a couple of passengers do decide to get off, but this was only the final stop for you three. So they do decide to get off and stretch their legs, and the cleric does some sort of healing spell on them before they go out and into the city.
I guess it's better than a flame strike. So.
As we go to exit, I'm going to attempt to polymorph old nasty eyes over here.
No need? No.
Greyhawk boy?
No, I'm good.
No? We good?
I'm good.
We fighting a priest today?
No.
I'll fight zombies all day, a priest. That's fucked up.
No, but I will try to avoid eye contact and keep my cloak up.
You recognize him. He's got some facial features that remind you a lot of your mother.
Grandpa!
Could be a family lineage here. My father did spend a lot
cousin.
Of...
Yeah,
could,
there we go.
It could be.
If you don't need polymorph, then I'm just going to... McNass is just going to exit the ship and get stretch his hooves and legs out.
Okay. Alright, so you come down. And the cleric says, "Hello, I'm sorry to be intrusive, but I'm going to need your left hand, please.
Look at my hands as if I don't know which one is my... Look at my hands as if I don't know which one is my left. I'm just going to offer it up. Just to confuse him.
Thank you. He takes you. He takes your hand and he rotates it so that your palm is down. He's holding it with one hand and then puts his other hand on top of your hand, and you feel a holy healing power go through you, and he heals you for 20 hit points and removes any curses or diseases from your body.
Oh, my fear of birds. Thank fuck.
Damn it.
Yes!
Is there any seagulls on the dock?
Nope. Yeah, I'm already good.
Too late.
He's good.
Yeah.
Could have been funny.
And then you can move along.
How many days has it been since our actual fight?
The whole trip was a little over 6 days, so it's been 3 days.
Right, plus I'm fully head. Healed at this point.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
All right.
I'll let Thaddeus go ahead.
Okay. Head down the ramp.
Gives you hand, heals you for 20 hit points, and removes any grossness.
He's going to fuck you up, dude.
And Malphaedor?
Okay.
You're trying to remove your curse and get like shot back like the exorcist. Like, oh, God!
Well, I've got my work cut out for me here, don't we?
Need an old priest and a young priest.
So, is it male or female?
It's a male.
Male. Alright. So, reach out.
He grabs your hand, puts it in his, just like normal, and says, "Forgive me, and I hope this does not cause you pain." And he heals you and does the same thing. 20 points and says, "What is your name, my fellow Azamar?"
My name's Bob, dude.
Can't resist a good call out. So I'll drop the hood. Says, "My name is Malphaedor Bromroyo."
Bromroyo. I know your father, Donato.
I wondered as much.
He grew up here with me. He's a good man. Very good man.
Yes, he's doing well.
Good. I love to hear that. My name is Wyatt. Wyatt So Juicy.
What the fuck?
God!
To be fair,
everyone froze at once, like, is Malphaedor dead, dude?
To be fair.
That was try it.
Yeah, try, I know, but like, try it derp.
Try it derp.
Don't just stop.
There are two NPCs here on Nortuga's Reef that I did not name. A fan reached out to me and asked me to put these names into this.
I take it this is fucking one.
Why it's So Juicy is one of the names.
What's the what's the fan's name? As I may need to fight them soon.
It is Emerald.
Okay.
Ooh, good. All right. Good, good. Chat line being started soon.
Yep.
Alrighty then.
I don't get on Discord for shit, but I'm about to have a conversation.
So, Emerald will be very happy to hear that you guys all stared at me waiting in anticipation for me to finish the pun.
Anticipation.
Yeah, welcome. Do you have a place to stay while you're here?
No, we don't. We literally just got off the boat.
Yeah.
I looked over like...
I understand. I would be honored if you would stay with me and my family.
We would be much obliged. Thank you.
Very good. I need to finish
absolutely.
The job here.
Absolutely.
There is a tavern in the town. There's only one tavern, and it is literally called The Tavern.
Should be easy to find, then.
Oh, wow. Good to see they try real fucking hard.
Nortuga's Reef is a very upfront community. I'm sure your father has told you a lot about the village.
He's told me quite a bit.
So, meet me there for dinner. I will supply dinner for you. Are these your... He notices that Thaddeus and McNasley are both standing there waiting. Are these your traveling companions?
Yes, they are.
Oh.
We are all adventurers from Gagni.
My friends... You are welcome to stay with me as well. Dinner. I will buy dinner at the tavern.
Awesome.
Free meal.
So dinner, I take it? I feel like you said the word dinner a few times.
I'm a really big fan of food.
Oh, I'm a goat. Trust me. Like food. Big in.
Yes.
He's a fluffy, thick Azamar. Most of them are like body
really?
Models. They're like,
so really,
yeah.
He's rocking the dad.
Mr. Juicy's on the thick side, huh?
It's So Juicy is his last name.
So Juicy.
Wyatt So Juicy.
Good. It's going to be Wyatt from now on. Very happy with that.
You will call him Mr. Sojuicy. You will show this man respect.
He's a priest. It's Father Sojuicy.
Oh, you just wanted to make that joke. You're trying to figure that one out, weren't you? You've been working on that one for a minute.
You will show this man of the cloth the respect he deserves.
Friar Sojuicy.
You're going straight to hell for that one.
All right.
Fucking God.
So wander into the city.
All right.
Let's find this tavern. I want a wine.
My brain hurts.
All right. So you guys get to the tavern. Inside the tavern, there's just the one person who, the bartender who's there, you know, they'll make up whatever food you want. And they're like, well, with what we've got, we got a stew on, they've got some booze.
Well, after a week of that horrible, smelly ship and what was left of their tainted food.
I forgot to note, you guys got rid of all of the water. When you destroy the rune, it destroyed the water as well. So you've been drinking straight alcohol for the last 3 days.
Cool.
So you are dehydrated?
Well, hold on.
So we're living,
I would think
living
after
my
the
life.
First, the, after the first day, we would figure that out, and I would transfer spells over to a create water.
Okay. All right, cool. You can definitely do that. Yep.
I refuse to drink his water. If I have an excuse to be wasted for 3 days on a boat, and...
Oh, yeah.
Drink your lemonade.
Beta definitely had some rum for you. Lots and lots of rum. So you made it to the tavern. You get to eat some real food and drink real water.
How big is Nortuga's Reef? Like, is there a library? I want to try to look up McNasty's sword and get an idea of what is going to happen when the souls fill up. Would they have a library? Some sort of... like a, I don't know, wizard's college?
They don't have any colleges here. They do have a library, though.
What time is it? Like, early afternoon? Do I have a couple hours till dinner?
Yeah.
Okay. So, have a quick lunch, and then go to the library and look and see if I can find anything on the Nine Lives Scimitar.
Okay. Yeah. So, you go to the library. Go ahead and make your investigation roll.
I'm just going to pull up. I can see my item screen.
Yeah, 11. Shopping.
An 11?
Yeah.
So yeah, you don't even find any books that have the Nine Lives Scimitar in the
Their books don't even have scimitars. Don't know what the fuck's up.
You only had a couple hours to look, though. Yeah. Maybe with more time you could find stuff, but with only having a couple hours before dinner, you just couldn't lock into anything.
Okay. All right, and then after I get done looking, I'll head back to the tavern.
Okay. You two do anything, or you just finally relax after being on the boat?
I'm chilling at the tavern.
I'm looking for one thing. Is there potentially a music shop in the city? Or a bard's college of any type?
There's no bard's colleges.
No colleges.
Oh, yeah.
So you ask the tavern keep if there is a music shop, and she says, there's not really a music shop. There is a few different people around here who can make musical instruments for you if you commission them.
Good. I have to be directed to whoever the closest or at least the most popular is.
Well, there are several, depending on what you're looking for. Are you looking for a lute? Are you looking for a woodwind instrument? Stringed instruments? I mean, they're different.
Very similar to a lute. I would go along that line.
A lute? Oh,
a kazoos, specifically.
A lute.
Oh, not a lute. I was thinking a flute.
A flute? Yeah. A woodwind instrument.
Woodwind. That's the one. I didn't do fucking a band.
Yes, I have a very good friend named Ali. She'll be able to help you with it.
I feel like you're prepared for this, which is terrifying.
What is Ali's last name?
Oh,
I'm not
oh,
there.
Oh, you're there. Yeah, you're not there.
I just... You said there were two.
That's my problem. I knew there was going to be another. It's going to be something. He's too prepared. Like, he had a name way faster than typical, which means there's something going on. Yeah, I'm going to go definitely meet with Ollie and attempt to commission a couple hundred kazoos.
She's one street over and maybe a block down. You look for the house. It's got a sign on the front. Last name is Durout.
Throw that back? What?
Which part?
The last bit. Last name's what?
Durout.
Ah, damn it! Got it.
No, I'm missing.
I'll eat her out. God, I hate it. God!
Again, not mine.
Tarout. I thought you said duh.
Emerald, not me.
It took me a second, like, on the name, because I thought it was a D2. I was like, it's not. And fuck it. I clicked in place.
Did they pay you for this? Yeah.
Well, I'm going to go to Miss Trouts.
Trout.
Or house, Miss or Mrs. or Mr. Whatever the fuck's going on here. I'll go to Miss the Trout's house. And knock on the door. And
so you get there, you knock on the door, and Ollie comes to the door. She's like, hello. How can I help you, now?
Hi, I was looking... Fuck, I used my server voice. I didn't even use my, like, my normal voice. I was looking to see if I could commission a few instruments from you.
Oh, I'll be. Yeah, you can definitely get one from me. What you got in mind?
Oh, God, my brain hurts. Kazoos, if possible. Some very similar to this, and I pull out one of my just standard kazoos.
Huh. Yeah. I could do something like that pretty easy. You got a time frame in mind?
Fucking what?
A time frame. Time. When you need it.
You don't have subtitles over there.
I feel like he's watching a bunch of Australian TV just to get this going. About how long do you think one would take?
Yeah, a couple hours at most.
How long are we in the city? Probably not long, I would
not
assume.
Not long. Yeah.
Probably just like a day or two.
2 days tops.
As many as you can make in 2 days.
Aw. I'll see what I can do.
But how much would they be?
Oh, yeah. What do you want made out of?
What?
What do you want it made out of?
I think just wood would be fine. A nicer hardwood if you have it.
Yeah, I can do that.
Nice hardwood.
Good hardwood instrument to blow on.
Hardwood between his lips.
Stop it!
What was the price for a nice hardwood kazoo?
I think I'd probably do a few a day. Maybe 3 gold each.
Yeah, I got lots of gold in mine, sorry. I don't know why I had to look. For a member of Gagny in a bulk order, would 2 gold each perhaps be a fair offer?
Make a roll.
Fuck yeah, 19.
She looks down and looks back up at you and kind of looks at your cloak and says, yeah, I could do that. That's 2 gold each, fair.
All right. I'll pay as soon as I know how many were able to construct it.
Ah, leave me one down there. Right there.
What?
Leave me one now.
1 gold?
No. One a kazoo.
Oh, god damn it. I'll leave one of my standard kazoos.
Alright. Yeah, see you when you're back.
I'll be back.
Piss off. Shuts the door.
After that, I need a drink. I'm going down to the bar.
Yeah, I feel like I need a real drink, too.
Fucking.
Anyway, alright. So, Malphaedor, what are you wanting to do here?
Fucking kill himself after
well,
he got in. Accident.
Did Wyatt give us any time of when he would be back around?
He said dinner. If you're ready to jump to that, we can jump to that.
Because with him wandering off to the library and with him wandering off to do God knows what, I would feel obligated to kind of set up base camp at the tavern and wait for Wyatt to show up.
Okay. You can definitely do that. Yeah. Yeah. It only takes him a couple hours. He gets everybody off the ship that wants to get off. And
only took him a couple hours to get everybody off, huh?
So juicy.
Nice guy.
Sweet mother of God!
He ends up coming to the tavern, and he says, oh, I'm glad you waited here. It's nice to see you.
Yes. Well, my companions seemed they wanted to do some sightseeing, but I figured it would be prudent for me to wait for you here.
Yeah, the sights around Nortuga's Reef are worth seeing.
I look forward to it.
So what brings you to town?
Well, that's a bit of a long story. Perhaps we can get into the length and breadth of it after dinner.
Sure. Are your companions arriving shortly?
It's hard to say with these two. Why don't we just go ahead and start without them?
Very good. Well, let me get a bottle of wine. And he stands up to go to the bar and get the wine, and a few moments later, the other two come walking back in at the exact same time because it's a show. And that's more convenient. And he sits down 2 goblets, one for him, one for you, and the bottle of wine, just as the other two come back in.
Okay. So I will, see if I can catch the barmaid's attention to get two more glasses.
Yeah, you motion two more glasses, and she nods and brings them to you.
Weren't sure if you guys were showing up.
Wouldn't miss out on free drink and food.
Yeah, free food.
I'll start pouring the wine.
So, long of it now.
Well, as you know, the three of us are affiliated with Gagny. And
this dude's long of it.
We have a bit of a situation which may have extended even to this area as well. Have you noticed anything strange happening with magic in general, specifically portal magic, but other odd fluxes?
Fluxes are something we always watch for here on the Isle. As far as portals go, it is not acceptable to cast portal magic in Nortuga's Reef.
Pay attention on me.
I'm paying attention.
In fact,
no portals from you.
Many of the shards of Isan have outlawed portal magic.
Is this a recent event, or?
No, these laws have been standing for hundreds of years.
Wonder if that has any bearing on the those old tales we've heard in the books.
Yeah, and the
Unbridled Wrath.
Yeah, that one. I couldn't think of the. I spaced on the name of it.
Mount Ovix, the portal of Mount Ovix.
Yeah.
So we have been noticing in our home territory around Cheddar on the Derry Coast. Strange fluctuations in magic, and we've discovered a problem with portals opening when they shouldn't be, or if they're open, they won't close. And one of our companions was recently caught in between two portals, and we're curious and concerned of his fate as far as that goes. But we've found that we may find some answers to what we're looking for in the shards of Isan.
What are you looking for in the shards?
What are we looking for?
Do we...
It's been a minute.
Great fucking question.
Yeah, it's,
We're looking for answers.
We haven't heard of Eterno, right?
You've heard of a bridge to cross over to the in-between at a weak point. Which is in the tower, or in the Mount Obix.
In Mount Obix, okay. Yeah. I wasn't sure if we'd heard if the archaeologist had given us the
You know that
city.
There's a place where it is possible to move into the in-between. Or at least that's what you've been told. There's a bridge to the in-between.
So we seek to possibly rescue our friend and also find a way to stabilize these fluxes that we've been encountering.
I'm glad you stumbled across me when getting off the boat. Some of the things that you say are very concerning to our people here. And while we are very proud people here in Nortuga's Reef, we live in kind of a different manner. We believe that there is a balance to all things. To chaotic magic versus ordered magic, and that when one magic is stronger than the other, they will eventually balance themselves out. There will be a disturbance in how life plays out for all of us until that disturbance is ended. But, for example, if you take and you make one very powerful wizard who thrives off chaos magic, then you may see a lot of other wizards, less powerful, but they all have a small amount of order magic. And it balances in the grand scheme of things, even though one person is much more powerful than one of the chaos person would be much more powerful than the order person. The idea here is that when we open portals to other realms, we upset that balance because we're pulling more power, whether it be chaos or order, from those other realms. so we should not open portals. That is why it is against the laws of nature. Those portals don't take you to other locations. They bridge through other universes. Now, is there a place at Mount Obix where you can bridge that gap to the in-between? Yes. Could something very potentially bad happen? Yes, very much so.
We're trying to stop that very bad thing from happening. That's why we need to go to the bridge. Find our friend who's stuck there and try to close these portals for good.
That's like saying you're trying to put out a house fire by throwing gasoline on it.
I mean, it'll burn itself out, right? Eventually.
It will, but everything will be destroyed.
It can be rebuilt.
It'll be safely destroyed. Destroyed with purpose?
These portals are opening all over the world. We need to try to stop them.
How many portals have opened?
I don't have
probably half a dozen.
Probably more than that.
More than that now. Yeah.
I'm sure. I don't have an exact number, but they're opening. Nobody is opening them. They're opening themselves. So if we can go into the in-between, save our friend, and destroy whatever is opening these portals, it'll save a lot more people.
How committed are you to this quest?
Well, we've traveled halfway across the world and fought countless disgusting beings. So at this point,
pretty
about
committed.
As committed as you can be.
We didn't come all this way for nothing.
You could almost say it was the main story of our lives.
That main quest, man.
Yeah.
Well, if you are certain that we cannot sway you from this quest, I can tell you how to get to Mount Obix. Where the bridge is once you're there, I do not know. But I'm sure the signs will be there. I'm sure if you are fully capable of actually stopping this, then you'll be able to find it. There are old legends about why the portals are not allowed around here, aside from the balance. Many of those legends involve a small town that probably doesn't exist. It is said to be surrounded by a plant called a sun shroom. It's a mushroom that grows in sunshine, direct sunlight. And you see fields and fields of it. Now, most people around the Shards of Isan won't even travel to Mount Obix. It is a cursed place. But every shard of Isan is connected to Mount Obix with a bridge. It's the only way to get to Mount Obix. Ships can't go there. They quite frequently will be destroyed by whatever random event that happens. So you have to walk it. But walking the bridge to Mount Obix is dangerous. You can't step off. You don't just fall into the water. You fall out of space and time. Someplace else. People don't come back. And the bridge is narrow. Full of danger. I can take you to it.
In the morning?
Yeah.
I have a small task in town to retool my inventory. Can we go tomorrow morning?
How long do you need?
Only one
day. It's the evening, so yes.
Sorry?
It would be tomorrow morning.
2 days morning.
No. This is more important than whatever. You're getting more kazoos, aren't you?
More weapons equals more damage.
By
at
noon,
least from me.
By noon tomorrow, we're not going to stay a whole extra day. We need to.
I mean, if we're here until noon, that means we have lunch, maybe a drink.
No, we leave by noon at the latest tomorrow.
I'll check my supplier. You might want to check in as well. You might need a little handcrafted wooden trinket. His name is Allie Trout.
I will reach across the table and refill Wyatt's drink. And as I do, I will say to him in Celestial, I would like to have a private conversation with you later. Just the two of us.
Sure. Let's finish our meal here, and then we'll head to my house. Then we'll have plenty of opportunity for one-on-one conversations.
Good.
Did he say that in Celestial?
Yeah.
Okay.
I would hope he's kind of discreet.
What's fucking rude, Mal?
Yeah.
What the hell?
Yeah, we're supposed to just... Me and the old man just sitting here like, what the fuck is that?
Just start speaking Sylvan.
Yeah.
Wait, do I speak Sylvan? I do speak Sylvan. We're good.
Sweet.
We're going to talk shit about them in Sylvan.
I'm not going to talk to you in Sylvan.
We interrupt this program for a special news announcement. Flash! A Fool's Quest fever is sweeping the globe, causing sudden fits of laughing out loud and an anxious feeling while waiting on the next episode to release. The only known cure so far is, no, not more cowbell, more Fool's Quest! We now return you to your regularly scheduled program after this brief message from our sponsors.
Hey, it's James.
I'm Paul.
And Chip from Roll Britannia,
a British Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition podcast with a piratey theme. And we pick up our story in a tavern.
Fine, honestly. Milo! Hello, mate. How's it going?
How many of you
No, I'm fine. But I could do with your help. I've got this chap here. Right? He's like an old captain or something. But he's got these amazing stories. But there's this one he's just not telling me. And I think you could help me convince him. And then we could tell the world. But... to do this, we are going to need a lot of rum. So can you get a lot of rum?
Barkeep.
Hey?
Can I get a bottle of rum?
Yeah, of course you can, mate. Free gold, please, thank you.
Grab the bottle. Come with
me. All right.
Mr. Captain, this is my friend. He would love to hear that story that you were going to tell me. And here is your rum.
What be your name, young halfling?
Milo Toscobble.
Toscobble, eh? I knew a Toscobble. Pleased to make your acquaintance.
And please, will you tell us that story? Come on, I've asked you, please.
Okay. Take a seat. You asked me once to tell you the greatest tale of all time. Well, four young fools set a course for adventure and a life on the high seas, but found themselves indentured aboard a ship which met with a monstrous fate. But as it turned out, that voyage opened the gate. Now lo, they came from humble beginnings. I seen them defeat creatures you don't even believe in. They set sail from the Sword Coast across the Shattered Lands, and in the creation of this world in which we now be living, one thing's for certain, they had their hands. So if you'll fill up me tankard to the top with rum, and prepare to set sail for where it all begun, I'll tell you that tale all across the millennia. Listen close now, as we row Britannia.
It's intermission time, folks. So hurry, hurry, hurry. Step right over to our refreshment center for the most extravagant array of refreshment goodies ever assembled under one roof. Enjoy breathtaking, mouth-watering goodies. Everything from a snack to a delicious full meal. At our refreshment center, you'll find a large variety of goodies to satisfy your hunger, your thirst, or your sweet tooth. So hurry, hurry, hurry. Visit our refreshment center now.
Get on with it.
Yes, get on with it.
Oh, I am enjoying this scene.
Get on with it.
And now, on with the show.
Let's join the drow rogue Ayda, the gladiator bard Francis the Lion, and the rogue warlock Hesh von Eggars as they conspire together to thwart the progress of those gag-me fools. Beware, there be villains here.
Before we start this whole heist situation... Hef, you're gonna open the vault.
Yep.
Give my money.
Yeah. Let's go downstairs.
Great. As we're walking, should we go get fried before getting the mech onto the ship?
Now that you're in there, do you just want to get the mech onto the ship?
And, I mean, since it's been modified to work thusly, do we even need fried?
Only if we want others. But no.
Keen mind would tell you that Hef just explained to you that he designed this.
Yes, I mean, we've got Hef as well.
Keen mind.
I don't think we need fried. We can just burn him with the rest of them.
I'm changing my name from Dungeon Master to Keen Mind.
Please do it.
little KM
action. Great. No, don't need fright. As my Keen Mind just told me.
You just go from Sean Connery to Russian?
Listen, I want to tell you something.
Jolka.
It's like I've just turned drumming. Mind business. Open vault.
Still Sean Connery, but the R is backwards.
Didn't Sean Connery do a Russian accent in a movie?
I don't know, probably. Yes.
Like all of them?
Okay, so the basement opens.
Oh, is it an underground basement?
Yeah. No, it's not. It's a normal basement.
I was going to say, you have the equipment now.
And you guys hear a...
My shirt over my mouth.
Yes.
Do you walk down the... There's stairs that line...
Is it trapped?
Stairs... No traps.
All right, then go in.
He walks down.
All right.
I can still use weapons in this thing, right?
Yeah.
All right.
I follow.
Yeah, I'm going to follow too.
Yeah, okay. You can only use one-handed weapons if you're going to use your bonus action.
Okay.
Because it's a big ol' blaster.
Yeah.
I do pull my rapier, though.
Okay.
I pull out the rod of lordly might, and you know what? I'm pushing a button.
Oh, shit. Does my rapier is just plain Jane, not lit up?
It is a light buzz.
Okay.
Nothing too crazy.
Well, I pushed button 5, which transforms it into a handheld battering ram.
Which gives you a +10 bonus to strength checks made to break through doors, barricades, and other barriers.
Dude, this is kind of
perfect.
Can
I just remind you what you look like right now?
Yes. Yes.
It looks like a gargoyle.
Yeah.
The head has a mane and large pointy ears and a bat tail. That is what you look like right now. Just so you know.
And
with
I have
a battering ram.
Battering ram.
And a butler behind him.
False butler.
Butt guard.
So your strength is effectively 35 to break through a door.
Yeah, yeah.
To get into a vault.
+17 to my roll to break through a door.
Yeah, to get into a vault. That could not have worked out any better.
Nope.
Right. So are we at the door?
All right, so you guys went down the stairs. Your rapier starts buzzing a little bit, and you do see a big-ass golem, and he's like...
Hey, who goes there?
Oh, it's just me. You recognize me, right? You've seen this before.
I have seen the... excuse me, it's been a rough day. Is it Monday? It feels like a Monday.
Probably, who knows.
What do you want?
I just gotta go in the vault.
No one goes in the vault.
And he tries to take a step towards you, and then he, like, spews out golem play.
F, where is the power source to this?
I assume it's inside.
Yeah, which body part?
I think these golems are, I think it's in their left leg.
Dispel magic.
Does it have to make a save for dispel magic?
It depends on how high this spell level is for the construct. If it's third level or lower, it gets dispelled.
Okay.
Otherwise, I have to make an arcana check.
It would be...
Just fucking power this bitch down.
I had the golem stats all put together. I just didn't know what the roll would be for its brain source. Jesus. So you can make it... I would probably say it's a level 5 spell golem for the magic. I chopped its life down a good chunk by making it sick. I made it puke up clay all over you.
So, if I did do Dispel, and it would have advantage on it. Nope, that's a 7.
Okay, so you cast your spell at it, and it says...
Stop that.
Oh, that's fair. All right. Have fun, you stand over here with me. We're gonna stand over here. Go on, do other things.
I'm gonna push that button again so it turns back into just a rod. And then I'm just gonna
vault. But the vault.
Oh, I can turn it back into the battering ram.
But it's at random. How many times can you hit it?
Well, I identified that button, so I can just push that button. It's six buttons. Six different buttons.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that...
Okay, my bad.
He doesn't know what the six buttons do, but as he pushes them, he is figuring them
out.
Gotcha.
Yeah. So, I'm going to turn it back into a rod, which can be used as a mace with a plus three bonus. And I am going to just... I'm going to look at Hesh as not Fred.
Not Fred.
And look back at the golem and... point at the mace and shrug.
Hurry up. Okay. I have shit to do.
Then I'm going to walk over there and just smack it a couple of times.
So, Not Fred is pushing Hef back against the wall and, protecting him.
And Not Fred says, I don't think I'm, so different than your average, average. I can help.
Shh. Sweet boy. Keep your mouth shut. Papa's headache's still raging.
These columns are crazy, Life finds a way.
What do you go check under the golem's skirts?
Yeah, first it's the oohs and the ahs, and then it's the running and the screaming.
These gnomes were so preoccupied with whether whether or not they could. They didn't stop to think about they should. I'm sorry, guys.
So we got a 26 to hit with one and a 10 to hit with the other.
Wow! The armor class is 20.
Okay, so I hit with one.
Yep.
That does 4 damage.
Okay.
just bonked him once.
Stop that.
And I have already used my bonus action, so I can't use the big old blaster. So, yeah, all right, there we go.
Should we do initiative?
Yeah, we can do initiative. And then we're also going to roll initiative for Ayda, because Ada's doing something on the side. So we'll loop in Ada's business while you guys are fighting this golem.
I got a 17.
Yep, that's a 7.
I got a 4.
I got a nat 20.
Nat 20. Bop, 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 yeah. Bop.
Yay.
Oh, you have initiative, or advantage on your...
So did I. Oh, yeah, that's
and
right.
I got a 1 the second time.
I got a 22.
Okay.
Dang. Can I roll for Hef?
Mine was actually a 29, if you want
to... Hef's not actually going to be in combat.
He fucking lied to me.
He'll run away. He did. He has no superpowers without his beard. Ayda, what are you doing right now while this is happening?
Is this still early morning? Because that really...
Yeah, this is like 2 o'clock. Or no, this is like 2 o'clock. It's before 3.
2 o'clock, so... Mm-hmm.
You just finished getting your hair done. That took 2 hours.
And then I did some light yoga.
Okay.
God damn it.
Sebastian joined you, actually.
He was watching.
Yeah.
He's an instructor.
Yeah.
He was helping.
Good form, ma'am.
Shower thought. I activated my belt. Sorry. I would be definitely doing my makeup. I don't really need to disguise at all, really, at this point. So just doing makeup, not covering the ring or nothing.
I like to think of this as like a movie montage where like you two are in combat in a fight scene and Ada's like, yeah, she's doing yoga right now. You guys attack the golem. The golem attacks you. Flashes back to Ada. She's popping some grapes in her mouth.
A light snack, a little appetizer before the big feast.
calls HBO back into the room.
Flips through them doing stuff.
Getting dressed will require tactically hiding my weapons.
Okay, yeah.
So I'm just gonna appear to be unarmed, but underneath the cloak that I'm gonna wear over my dress, because it's winter time, right?
Yep.
So I'll have this big cloak that I'll have over my dress, covering my bow, my rapier. Just under one of the folds of my skirt.
Yeah.
And of course the bracelet. Slap dagger is just a bracelet at the time. Making sure he takes care with our luggage. Lugging it down to the boat because it's about 2 o'clock.
Yeah.
Around 2:30 or so. He'll be getting around and making his way. And then I order him to meet me back at the hotel by 3:30.
Okay. With Captain Murphy.
With Captain Murphy in tow.
All right, it is over to Hesh's turn.
He needs to make a wisdom saving throw. He has advantage on it for Toll the Dead. And then I also missed with an Eldritch Blast.
He got a 12.
Alright, so he fails. So that's 2d for 3 damage. So that orange and green, like, sickish silhouette of, like, the kind of mirage type of bell goes around this golem and shakes, and everyone hears a thoom, thoom.
Alright.
Yeah, I'm not going to hit another button. I'm just going to smack him with it and then shoot him. That's a crit. And also, what was his armor class?
20.
Okay, a crit and a miss. But let me reroll that crit. Okay, so I hit with the crit.
That's damage!
For 15 damage.
Damn.
And then the big old blaster, does that use like ranged attack mechanics?
Yep.
Alright, so I'll have disadvantage since I'm in melee. And that'll just miss. Oh, that's a 1.
What is your major malfunction, numbnut?
And a 7.
Okay, so it shoots the wall, and it leaves a big chunk right behind the golem's head, and he's like,
why?
Oh, whoops! I don't know how to work this. I'm new.
Yeah.
Should have let us in the vault.
Come here.
And it's his turn now, right?
Yeah.
So he makes his way over to Francis, and he goes to strike twice.
The lion?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shit.
In your mech suit. And, oh, the mech suit has 100 hit points.
Okay.
So you can use somebody to repair it later to give it more hit points back, or after it hits 0, or -1, it is effectively completely destroyed.
Okay, I just put it in note.
So, his first attack is a 17, which is a miss.
Yes.
And then the second attack is a 22.
Which is also a miss.
Also a miss. So actually, he doesn't miss. He takes his large blade, draws it out, and he just brings it down and hits you on your mech suit. Once on the shoulder, and then once on the arm. But your mech suit is strong enough to adjust... take those hits without incurring any real damage. And then he pukes.
But I'm in the mech suit. Do I need to make a con save?
You do not.
Okay.
You do not.
That's fortunate. But it's sticky.
But it does look very poisonous. And so that Hesh and Hef realize, if that gets on you, you probably will have to make a con save. And it is back to Ayda. So what are you doing in your montage now?
I will go to a gift shop real quick to purchase a box.
Okay.
A very large box and some wrapping paper and a bow.
Okay.
And then I will wrap that box in the wrapping paper and make my way on a nice leisurely stroll with my bodyguard on the way to the party.
He's got his arm, like, wrapped through your arm. You're like, you guys are walking arm in arm, you know, just casually. He's holding an umbrella, like a parasol above you.
Yes.
As you guys move along, and over to Hesh.
How big is it? Is it a large creature?
An iron golem is a large construct, yes. Okay. So it's large. So it's big.
I want to toll the dead again and then fire another Eldritch Blast at it. So it needs to make a wisdom DC 17. It has advantage. And I rolled a 14, which is a miss.
Got an 18 to save.
Okay. So. And then. Two different spells that make two different sounds.
Neither of them are doing any good.
Yeah.
All right. It is Francis's turn.
Just one quick question about the mech suit. When I fired the big old blaster, was there like comic letters spelling kapow?
Yep.
Okay.
Sure was.
I'm gonna hit him again with the rod, which that's gonna be a 21 and a 22. That's 9 damage and 4 damage.
Okay.
And then I'm going to go for a blammo this time.
Okay.
20.
A crit 20 or a...
No.
Flask of 20.
Flask of 20. Borrowing these two dice.
Yeah.
That's 15.
Wow. Ew. Indeed.
Did I get that blammo?
Yeah, what is the blammo?
It's like the Batman, you know, zap.
Oh, yes. Kapow. Yes.
They have the onomatopoeias come out in flag form.
Yeah. Yes. You got it.
All right. Perfect.
And it is over to the mech's turn. Or, no, to the golem's turn. And the golem's going to attack you again.
Heck yes, he is.
And he takes his giant sword and he swings down on you again, hits your armor, and then very angrily tries to thrust forward to stab it right through you, but it deflects and goes off to the side. Both attacks miss. And then he goes...
Again.
And it's like all over the floor.
So gross.
Clay vomit.
Disgusting.
Gritty.
And Ayda, where are you at in your montage? What's...
So I will... arrive at the party in front of Build-A-Mech, where you guys are still inside.
Mm-hmm.
Making all kinds of noise, I assume. Is there a band?
HBO's following you around still. So, yeah, you got the horned brass orchestra.
All right, so can I hear these guys at all?
I would probably say not. They're down in a basement in a secret room.
All right, just for shits and giggles, I'm going to send HBO up on stage to... play some lively tunes to get everybody in the mood to party.
Yeah.
And make my way over to see Pink and have a nice little chat. I'm assuming the seafood restaurant is closed.
Yeah, because they're catering the event.
Okay, so I want to try to pick her pockets.
Okay.
Because how else am I going to get in?
Yeah, no, that makes sense.
Through the bathroom window, I guess.
Make your sleight of hand roll. All
right. Ooh, 14.
And Pink got a 13. So it was it took a little bit of conversation. There was a little bit of talking that had to go back
sitting
and
there,
forth. Yep.
Sebastian's following me with my plate and we're nibbling and chatting.
Just changed his name. And
I trip over a pebble.
Okay, yeah.
And kind of like grab her skirts or whatever she's wearing to kind of steady myself. And
yep. Yank the keys right out.
Get the keys.
And she does not notice.
All right, and then continue to browse the buffet of goods.
Yeah, all right. Hesh.
Point out which things for Sebastian to bag up.
All right, I'm going to try one last time, and if this doesn't yield what I want, I'm going to change up my tactics, but wisdom saving throw, get advantage, and then Eldritch Blast.
13.
Hey, nat 20.
Yay!
So, Eldritch Blast, but... Those are both ones. So that's two damage.
Yeah, so...
Don't you get...
What?
Two or three shots with Eldritch Blast?
Oh, yeah. It's 4d10 altogether. I get a secondary.
The good news is if you doubled that, or if you rolled it twice, it was still the same number.
That's true.
So, that's not good news. 2, 10, 12 damage. So that's 18 damage total.
Alright, Tony.
I'm Tony.
Say what?
Yep, you're also Francis.
I'm Francis.
The lion.
The lion.
You guys have like 2 hours.
Okay. Yeah, I'm just gonna just wail on him some more. Smack him in his... I'm gonna miss. I'm gonna try to hit him right in his big iron head and just miss.
You're still learning the controls.
Yeah, it's like new shoes, like a trip.
Yeah, clay all over the floor.
Yeah, it's a little slimy and sticky and it's disgusting.
Yeah.
I'm still gonna try to shoot him. And miss with that too. Probably just straight up into the ceiling.
How close is the golem to the wall?
He stepped about 10 feet away from the wall to go attack Tony, go attack Francis in the mech suit.
I'm going to move around the other side of him and back right up to the wall.
All right. And then he's going to turn around and try to attack you again, and his highest roll is a 19. So he goes to swing, and both hits on your armor, and he is like,
ugh!
And he turns his head briefly and vomits toward Hesh and Hef.
Damn, I was trying to draw him away.
And you guys are going to need a DC 19 constitution save.
I made it. 19. 17 plus 2.
Nice. Hef made it. Holy fuck. All right. So you both jump apart, one to the left, one to the right, and his poison breath, which is clay vomit in this situation, lands against the wall and on the floor right between where you guys were. And Ayda, the buffet that you were looking at, it is, I mean, there's macaroni and cheese with hot dogs that are carved into little squids. There's peanut butter and jellies, peanut butter and honeys. But out of both those sandwich types, the crusts have been cut off. Okay. There's root beer and ice cream to make root beer floats. There is a cake that says Happy 11-D-1st, Tubba, but it's like really big cake. There's also some rice frisky treats. Yeah, just a wide spread of children's Jell-O. Food. Oh, Jell-O.
Jell-O.
Yep, Jell-O's there. Yep, pudding. Yep.
So.
Goldfish.
Goldfish crackers.
By now, Sebastian's gotten to know me over the past 4 days, so he would have come prepared with a satchel.
Yes, of real baggies. Food. Yeah.
And I'll pick some up for the fellows because it seems like they're not going to make it in time to get any of this. So I'll just have them start like stuffing the bag full of goodies and then like go over to the cake and just run my finger through the frosting and try it.
It's and pretty then, good. It's high quality frosting there.
And then like start murmurs, you know, like, what time is it?
Yeah, we're coming like right on 3 o'clock. So we're almost there.
Okay.
And then Hesh, I guess we're back to you.
Yeah,
Hesh is going to run up with the rapier drawing, and oh, first he's going to say, Hef, get your lash up there and don't leave the building. Be safe. And then pull a short sword with his offhand, run up behind.
Hef is running up the stairs and he said, did he say be shave? He feels the feels the dwarven stubble on his beard.
Freshly shorn. Oh, you know why. No eye contact.
Thought we were past this.
Why are you crying?
Stop it!
Anyway, go ahead.
Rapier in the right hand, short sword in left. Two weapon fighting. Plow. So that's a miss and a hit. So this is the offhand. So my short sword hits. That is 8-9 demo.
Francis.
Yeah, I'm just going to smack him again with that mace. Or, well, try to. That'll hit once. 4-9.
Okay.
And then instead of trying to shoot him, I'm going to say, you know what, Hesh? You're doing a fantastic job. And give him an inspiration die.
Okay. He feels inspired.
For the podcast, I'm giddy.
And Hef runs upstairs and grabs the wheelbarrow with the sheet and takes it and stands by the door waiting for you guys to come up so he can do his job. And it is the golem's turn. So the golem, very, very angry now. His grip tightens really hard around his sword, and he just fully thrusts 2 times at Francis in the mech suit, and both times it misses. One to the left, one to the right, and both stab right into the wall.
All right. Is it the best you can do?
Yes. Why are you doing this? I don't even feel good.
I told you we just wanted in that vault. You could have. This is on you. You chose this.
You can't go into
this. See, you're still choosing it.
All right, Ayda.
So this is right before everything happens, like when the party begins?
Yeah.
Right?
Okay. The party's just about to begin.
I would have made small talk with everybody that had arrived, snacked throughout the whole thing. Brad Pitt, you know, mm-hmm. Always something in my hand. Eating something, and then just like make eyes at Sebastian, and like give the little head cock, like follow me,
mm-hmm.
and go in between the Isia and the Build-A-Mech,
mm-hmm.
and just spark a doobie with him.
All right, so you and Sebastian get really high before he's supposed to go collect the Captain Murphy. And after you two finish smoking, he leaves to go get Captain Murphy. And Hesh, let's go over to you.
Hey, what's up, buddy? With the rapier, I missed and used a bardic inspiration to miss harder.
Great.
Well, let's see. It's a plus 8. I rolled 8. It's a 16. Plus 1 is 17. So I missed pretty hard, and I was very sad about that. The offhand hit with a 26 and does a whopping, so 8 damage.
I'm going to say that's okay. Try again. That's my bonus action. And then I'm going to attack him with advantage. And that's going to miss. And that will hit.
What on those hit?
4, 6. And then that'll cancel out the disadvantage for the ranged attack, and I'll miss anyway. So 6 damage.
We're doing it, Peter.
I'm chipping away.
We're starting to believe.
6 damage does it.
Yeah. Oh. I swing the first time and miss. And just nail the wall right next to his head, and then I say, or no, I don't hit the wall because the wall's behind.
Yeah,
but yeah, I just miss, kind of just glance off his shoulder or something, and say, hold on, and I just measure off, put my hand on his chest, and really wind it up, and just bonk him right on top of the head, and just flatten his head a little bit, squish it down into his shoulders.
And he golem shits himself to death.
The bigger they are, the harder they shit.
Worst day.
I think that's the cold.
Ever.
Not Alfred puts his sunglasses on and you hear. Yeah!
This concludes this episode of A Fool's Quest. Join us next time for more fun and daring adventure. Thank you for listening, and don't forget to like, subscribe, review, and comment on your favorite platform to listen to A Fool's Quest.
Yay!